Watu wakajado hamjambo. Hamjambo tena. Mimi nilikuwa hapa tarehe 3 mwezi wa 9 mwaka 2018. Na nilizindua hii mradi. Hii ya Olkejuado University of Applied Technology. Ni kweli si kweli? Sijui kama tunaelewana. Sasa leo 2024 nimerudi hapa ili kuangalia hii mradi. Kwa bahati mbaya mimi nimepata kwamba gate imeenda na hata fence imechukuliwa na wahuni. Ni kweli si kweli? Sijui kama tunaelewana. Mimi na huyo gavana wenu Olelenku tulikuwa tumeweka zaidi ya 600 million mpango ya hii mradi. Lakini sasa nitaenda nikarabati. Kwa hii finance bill imekuja. Sasa nitapanga pesa ingine 1.2 billion ya kazi ya hawa vijana. Si hapa kukijengwa university kutakuwa na hostels. Na zikutakuwa na mama ya chakula. Na sikutakuwa na watu ya kubeba na boda boda. Ni kweli si kweli?
This is one of the Fambaya Diary exposes by Mr. Murara himself. This man has been going around the country exposing some of the ghost projects which have been launched by the president himself. Using his comic method of approach, this guy has decided to single-handedly do civic education to the Kenyan citizen who may be ignorant and may be see that the president may be launching some project, but in the real sense, these projects are really useless or they're non-existing. They're just something which is not going to work, something which is just there for PR stunts. So this guy has been praised by a lot of Kenyans who have been sponsoring him, and he himself has acknowledged that he has been receiving fuel from the people of Kenya, like in this clip you can listen and hear.
Previously on the Vampire Diaries.
Yeah. Wa Murara hamjambo. Hii ni Maumau Lot 2, sio? Hii ni Maumau Lot 2.
So now I'm at Mutati Tea Collection Center. We've been checking this road from Ikumbi, and this is the status of the road. Come, I show you. This is the status of the road. There's something else very painful I'm going to tell you about this road. Acha niwaangalie hapa. Now, on the day this road was launched by the president, Kenha made a procurement. It made a procurement to a company called Mosound Group Limited, and it paid them 2,217,751. And it was for putting up a holding or briefing room for the president, a holding area, a display, logistics and labor. Yani ile ku set up tent. Nini ile ribbon yenye president atakuja kukata kama hiyo yenye mmeona hapo ni kiclap. They spent 2,270,000. Hiyo ni yenye wali spend to set up hiyo kipindi. Now, not to talk about how much the president spent in fuel for his guzzlers together with the DP from Nairobi up to here. I'm here. This is Maumau Road Lot 2, Murang'a County. As you can see hapo ni Kenha. But there's something I want you to see up there. Project number Kenha 2205/2019. So I have only one question to our president. kama project number kwa Kenhan ya 2019, how did he manage to launch it in 2023? And after that launch, what has actually happened on the ground to date?
Watu wa Murang'a hamjambo! Hamjambo tena! Bwana asifiwe! Gaini mwega! Endo shiothe! Bas, mimi nimekuja hapa. Nilikuwa hapa mwaka uliopita.
So by using this comic approach, this guy has been traversing the country looking for those projects which the president has launched, and there have never been even be done anything to. And to shock of the reality is that the status might be panic, and we really hope this guy will be safe, because most of the whistleblowers have been abducted and been threatened. Like recently, Marvin Aoko, I think there's this lady by the name Marvin Aoko, he's a blogger and he's very vocal on X space. So I think she has been arrested, because even so, she has been so vocal about some things which become like the government never wanted them to talk about. So Mr. President Ruto is being exposed for launching several projects, some of which he had early launched while he was the deputy president. So who is fooling who? And Kenyans are feeling like this thing is becoming too much. This thing is being used to siphon money by the contractors and the procurement officers. So this civic education is what Kenyans need, and it has been going on. So this guy, after exposing the Kajiado University, he went ahead to expose the scandal of this road in Murang'a, and there is another project which he has also exposed. Just watch it in the next clip. Take your time and judge it.
Previously on the Vampire Diaries.
Nilidhani nachanganyikiwa kwa kusema hivi, kumbe ndivyo ulivyo, hakuna kupinga.
Welcome again to another episode of the Vampire Diaries. And today, I'm at Ngong Stadium. Now, this project was supposed to cost 198 million. So far, the contractor has already been paid 50 million. And I want to show you what 50 million looks like. So follow me. That is what 50 million looks like. Yeah. Milioni hamsini tangu wakati wa Governor David Ngedienye. Paka sasa wakati wa Governor Olelenku. Shilingi milioni hamsini. Yeah, so that is the half perimeter wall. So there is a perimeter wall on the front side. Let's just say stall projects is costing Kenyans a lot of money, because damaged infrastructure like this will take again millions of money to revive, and some of the things here are not usable. So I don't know why projects are not followed through to the end. And I don't know why money is paid to contractors for very piecemeal work that is done. Muna feel aje kuhusu hii stadium?
Hii stadium sisi hata tu feel po hata kidogo.
Yeah.
Hii nayo wametucheza tu. Hapa kuna kitu tumefanya.
Unaona ni kipindi?
Hii nayo ni movie.
Hebu wewe toa maoni yako, unaonaje?
Hii grao imekuwa hivi for a very long time, almost 10 years plus. County governor tukiangalia hakuna shughuli yoyote washai hata kuinvolve mavijana waambie grao yenyewe imefika hapa itaundwa lini, yani hakuna kitu yoyote tunaambiwa. So ndio tuli take initiative kama wana sporti Ngong Sport Association, tukaamua sisi wenyewe tujikombolee grao. Ndio hata ukiangalia hiyo grao tuliingia tukaanza polepole. Sasa hii tumeslash imefika hapo.
Wao nyinyi ndio umekuwa mkikata nyasi.
Ndio tumekuwa tukifanya shughuli. So
very
ni
nice.
Pole pole tu.
Yeah.
Na najua hii soon.
Yeah.
Tutaitumia.
So basically what we can learn is that there are some companies which are being used to siphon money from the public accounts or the treasury, because some of these individuals are using their procurement companies to siphon money, yet they deliver nothing. They just deliver air. Because if you look at this stadium or as many other stadiums in the country, there's something wrong going on in Kenya, and people need to realize that they need to come up and expose such projects. Many Kenyans have just woken up and they are really going hard on this issue of fake projects which are being launched here and there, and yet the president go to the press to say that there is no money for etc. ABCD. So comment down what you think about this story of Morara, and we will get to know more.